Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to model the multiplication of whole numbers and fractions. All right, so we're going to begin by doing the example 3 times 1 half. 3 is our number of wholes, so let's draw in 3 wholes. We're going to use circles here to depict our wholes. All right, each one of these wholes has to be broken in half because we see that, or split into 2 pieces. We see that based off the denominator in our fraction. So I'm going to draw some horizontal lines here. And then also that fraction is saying we need to shade in 1 out of those 2 pieces. So let's do our shading. All right, once the shading is completed, this really becomes just an exercise in counting. So here I have 1 half, and then I have 2 halves. Well, 2 halves make a whole, and then I have a remaining half. So this here is really 1 and a half. If you were to do this by converting each one of these pictures into their corresponding fractions, it would be 1 half plus 1 half plus a half. Whenever you add fractions, you know, you keep your denominators the same, and then you add your numerators. So this turns out to be 3 halves, and if you did the long division, 3 halves would come out to be 1 and a half when you change it into a mixed number. All right, for our next example, let's do 2 times 3/4. All right, this time we're going to do squares. We have 2 wholes, so I'm going to draw in 2 squares. Right, if you look at the fraction 3/4 has a denominator of 4, so that means each one of these squares needs to be broken into 4 equal pieces. So we'll do that by just doing a little cross in each one. And then the numerator of this fraction says you need to shade in 3 of the 4 pieces. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right, again, once the shading has been completed, it becomes a counting exercise. So here I have 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, 4/4. Well, we know that 4/4 signifies 1 whole. And then we're left with 1/4, 2/4. So this is really 1 and 2/4, but this can also be simplified down. 2/4, we know, can be divided, numerator and denominator, divided by 2. So 2 divided by 2 gives me 1. And then 4 divided by 2 gives me 2. So this here also turns out to be 1 and a half. And if we were to convert each one of these pictures into their fractional equivalent, this here is 3/4. And the second one is also 3/4. Whenever we add fractions, these denominators stay the same. We add our numerators, 3 plus 3 to give us 6. We can simplify 6/4. Because 2 can be divided into both of them, which turns us into 3 halves. We see we have 3 halves up here, and we know 3 halves turns into 1 and 1 half when you do the division and change it into a mixed number. All right, for our last example, we're going to do, 4 times 2/5. All right, and this time we're just going to do some rectangles. So we're going to create 4 rectangles. All right, once the 4 rectangles are created, notice that our fraction is 2/5 and our denominator is a 5. So being that this denominator is a 5, that means that each one of these needs to be broken up into 5 equal pieces. And we do that by drawing 4 horizontal lines. All right, and as we do that for each one, we're really changing these into 5ths. All right, one more to go. And again, when we refer back to the fraction part tells us that we need to shade in 2 out of the 5. So let's go ahead and shade in 2 out of the 5. So 2, 2, 2, and 2. So now, again, back to a counting exercise. 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, 4/5, 5/5. Well, we know 5/5 is the same thing as 1. And then we have another 1/5, 2/5, 3/5. So this is really 1 and 3/5. And if we were to change these models into their abstractions, this would really be 2 fifths plus 2 fifths plus 2 fifths plus 2 fifths. Let's go ahead and do that. So really it's just 2 fifths 4 times. All right, we keep that denominator the same, which is 5. And then we add up all these 2s, 2, 4, 6, 8. So this is really 8 fifths as an improper fraction. When we do the division, 5 goes into 8 one whole time. We have a remainder of 3. And then our divisor is a 5, so we keep that denominator. So we see this model here represents 1 and 3 fifths. All right, that sums up this video on multiplying whole numbers and fractions. Please comment. And as always, thank you for watching.